Grim Falcon here, back with another Noob to Pro Redstone video. Today we're talking all about gates. No, not those kind of gates, logic gates. Logic gates do a thing based on a subset of inputs. In essence, they are decision makers. A NOT gate, or an inverter, is useful when you want opposing output from the given input. So if the input is on, the output would be off, and vice versa. The most simple way to pull this off is with a redstone torch. How this works is as the input powers the block, that shuts the torch off, shutting off the output. This variant is a subtraction inverter. Quite a simple design. Input powers the repeater, which shuts off the comparator. The lever behind the comparator gives full power signal, and the repeater puts full power signal into the side. The comparator does need to be in subtraction mode. This one can be modified with power levels to shut off when an input goes over a certain point. XOR gates, just like they sound, will be on when any of the inputs are on. The most simple of XOR gates, where inputs just power a redstone line that goes to the output, hook each input into that line and you are good to go. Then you have designs such as repeater isolator. Basically the same, but with a small change. The repeater isolates each input, still the output remains on when any of the inputs are powered. This design is a one wide vertical XOR gate. A very simple design. The lower input powers the repeater that powers the output line. The upper line powers the dust that shuts off the first torch. That shuts power off to the dust, which allows the second torch to turn on, and that powers the output line. NOR gates, not XOR gates. It's an inverted XOR gate. It is an XOR gate that shuts off when any line is powered. Again, super simple design here. Each input powers the top block, which in turn shuts off the torch, and that shuts off the output. This one is just a fancier version of the other one. Each input powers the block to shut off the torch. You could branch off any of these lines to add more inputs if you needed to. And gates are on only when all inputs are on. If only one input is turned on, the output remains off, and of course if all inputs are off, the output still remains off. Again, a pretty simple one here. Each input powers the block, which will turn off the torch on top. When both torches on top of the blocks are turned off, the dust between them shuts off. That allows the torch on the side of the block to turn on, powering the output. This one is a piston repeater AND gate. The first output powers the piston, which moves the block in front of the repeater. When the second output is on, the repeater is powered. If both inputs are on, the moving block is hard powered, allowing the signal to move through it and turn the output on. This one is a vertical AND gate. As lower input powers on, the dust powers on and shuts the torch off. The top input powers the dust that will turn off the top torch. When both torches are turned off, the output torch turns on. Next, we have the opposite of an AND gate, a NAND gate. It is an inverted AND gate. Again, we got a very simple one here. As each input gets powered on, it shuts the torch in front of it off. When both torches are off, the input gets shut off. We got a vertical NAND gate here. The lower input will shut off the lower torch, which turns off the line above it, turning on the final torch. If the lower input is powered and the top input gets powered, that turns the line back on, which will shut off the output torch, shutting off the output. An XOR gate, or a XOR gate, is only on when one input is on and one input is off. If both of the inputs are in the same state, either on or off, the output remains off. This first one is the most simple. As one input goes on, it shuts the torch on top and front of the block off, which turns on the output torch on that side. But if both inputs are on, the center torch turns off, shutting off both of the output torches. This is an observer piston XOR gate. It is a little restrictive in that two short of pulses can flip the output. Also, if the inputs come in at the same time or even just too close together, it can break the system. Still, it has its uses. As each input turns on, the observer detects the update and one tick pulses the sticky piston. An XNOR gate is an inverted XOR gate. It is on when both inputs are in the same state and are off when they are not. The first design is almost the same as the first XOR gate I showed you, with an added torch under the output. Once again, as each input gets powered, the torch on top in front of the corresponding block gets shut off, allowing the front redstone line to turn on, which shuts the output torch off. If both inputs are off, the center torch remains on, so that the front output line remains off and the output torch remains on. All right, guys, we're almost there. We just got to talk about imply gates. These are gates that are off only when a specific input is on and the other one is off. If the gate is in any other state, the output remains on, even if the second output is off and the first one is on. For example, if the trigger input gets turned on here, that shuts the torch off, turning the output off. But if I turn on the second input, that powers the output line and turns on the output. That took more attempts than I care to admit to get through. This one is pretty similar. As the trigger input is powered on, it'll turn the front torch on. But if the second input is on, it powers the line all the way to the output. Hindsight being 2020, I probably should have started with this design. And the final gate? Well, that is a fence gate. Right-clicking will toggle a state, which will determine whether or not you can walk through it. All right, everyone, sorry if I went through that a little bit fast, but if you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments below, and I'll answer them the best I can. That's it for today's episode. If you want to learn more, my next video is coming out on January 25th, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. And if this video was helpful to you, be sure to hit the like. And remember, your teeth are not the same age as you are.